tardes, chicos. ¿Cómo están el día de hoy? Espero que estén muy bien. Estamos dando inicio a nuestra sesión de Storytelling and Mindfulness. Les damos la más cordial bienvenida. Yo soy la maestra Alicia Cabrera del Service Design Strategies para los Colegios San Ángel. Y pues me da muchísimo gusto saludarlos y convivir con ustedes en esta sesión. Ustedes ya vieron, tenemos un cuento padrísimo que a mí me encanta demasiado. Espero que a ustedes también. Y pues va a estar con nosotros la maestra Berenice. Sé que ella es especial en todas estas ocasiones porque siempre tiene sorpresas y siempre tiene una caracterización excelente para estas historias dedicadas a ustedes. Así que chicos, espero que les encante. También tenemos nuestra actividad de Kahoot, así que vayan preparando su iPad para que puedan responder acertadamente en las preguntas y finalizaremos con nuestra actividad de mindfulness el día de hoy, que estará acá, será el responsable el maestro, el psicólogo César Sarmiento, así que también estén muy, muy atentos. Muy bien, chicos, pues los dejo con la maestra Berenice para que pueda platicarnos y darnos la historia el día de hoy. Hola, maestra.
Thank you, Miss Alice. Hello, everybody. How are you today? Good afternoon. I see a lot of happy faces here. And I'm so happy too to be here in this storytelling. Remember to pay attention to the story because at the final we have our Kahoot. And also stay tuned because we're going to have our mindfulness session after the Kahoot. So here we're going to start, and you have to pay attention to this. That is my story, okay? So here is Alice in Wonderland. It was a sunny afternoon, and Alice was sitting in the garden with her sister. She was reading a book, but she was so bored. Then she saw a little white rabbit with pink eyes running in front of her. Alice decided to leave her sister and follow the white rabbit. He checked his big pocket watch and shouted, "Oh dear, oh dear, I'm late." Then, in the blink of an eye, he disappeared down a rabbit hole. Alice was intrigued and very curious. "I must find out where the white rabbit goes in a such hurry," she said. What do you think is going to happen? Alice looked into the rabbit hole, of course. But then she fell down and down. "Oh my goodness, will it never end?" she thought. She finally landed in a long, narrow corridor that had many doors of many different sizes. There was also a table. And on it was a tiny gold key and a green bottle that said, "Drink me." Alice tried the key in every door until she found the right one. Oh, it is the little door behind the table, and I'm too big to fit. She was almost about to give up when she remembered the little bottle. And of course, she decided to drink the potion. Alice started shrinking so much that she was almost the size of a doll. She opened the door, quickly ran through it. And guess what? She found herself in a beautiful garden, and there was the white rabbit. again shouting, "Oh, my ears and whiskers, how late I'm getting, no time to say hello or goodbye." And he ran away very fast. Alice followed the path of the white rabbit, but couldn't find him. Sudden, a smiling Cheshire Cat appeared on a tree branch and said, "Oh, if I were looking for the white rabbit, I will ask the Mad Hatter." "Mad Hatter," said Alice. "No, thank you. I don't want to talk to mad people." "Oh, you can help that. Most everyone's mad here," the cat replied. "You may have noticed that I'm not all there myself." And with that, he disappeared. Alice continued to walk along until she found the Mad Hatter having a cup of tea with the March Hare, the both of them were bunched together at the corner of a large table. "No roll, no room," they cried out when they saw Alice coming. "There's plenty of room," said Alice indignantly, while they sat down in a large armchair. "You can join us if you tell us what is a raven like at writing this." "I do so, Lovel Riddles," said Alice. She thought about it a lot, but said, "I don't know why it is." "I don't know," said the March Hare. "I don't either," said the Hatter. "I think you might do something better with the time," Alice said. "That's a waste in asking riddles that have no answers." All of a sudden, the white rabbit came running and shouted, "I'm late, I'm late." The Mad Hatter looked at the rabbit's pocket watch and said, "No wonder you're late. Why, this watch is exactly 2 days slow." Then the white rabbit ran away again. "It would be so nice if something will make sense for a change," told Alice as she left the tea party and continued to follow the white rabbit. She arrived at a field full of roses where the Queen of Hearts was playing croquet, surrounded by her birds. The mallets were flamingos and the balls were hedgehogs. "Who are you? You look strange. Can you play croquet?" "I'm Alice." "Yes, I think I can," she replied. "Play with me," ordered the queen. "And let me win, or I will have your head cut off." And of a sudden, the hell was drawn off the spectators, and among them were the Mad Hatter, the March Hare, and the Cheshire Cat, and of course, the white rabbit. Alice grabbed a flamingo and prepared to take her shot. Amazingly, Alice hit the perfect shot. The queen in anger shouted, "Off with her head, off with her head." And immediately, the words grabbed Alice. "Let me go! You're nothing but a pack of cards," she screamed. Alice's head started to spin and she began feeling dizzier and dizzier. And then she felt like she was starting to faint. When suddenly, Alice felt someone gently shaking her shoulder. What do you think was that? Wake up, Alice. You've been sleeping far too long. It was her sister waking her up. It was all a dream after all. Or wasn't it? The end. Do you like the story, guys? Yes, you like the story. And it will be more great if you play the cajon now. Let's see if you remember. Okay. So I will share it now in a minute. Ready to play it? This is the pin game, guys. You can go to this page to play Kahoot. We're going to wait for you to join us. Thank you, Barbara. I see now that you are here with us. Who else is going to join? Paola, now it's here. Thank you, Paola. Edith is here too. Everybody can join, going to this page, and after that, put in the pin game. And of course, you can write your name to see that in that way we can see who is playing with us. Ilya is here, Roberto, Rodri, thank you. JD, thank you for joining us. You have to read carefully, guys, okay? There are some tricky questions, so you have to read carefully and choose, of course, the correct answer. You will have like 13 seconds or 1 minute. It depends on the question. We will have 10 questions if you are asking how many are there. So we have 10, okay? 10 questions. Okay, we're going to start in 1 minute more. We're going to let the chance to our participants to join us. 1 more minute, guys. Okay, so now we're going to start. Are you ready? And the first question is, of course, what's the name of the story? That's an easy one. 13 seconds. Now, I have 5 answers. Great. Well done, guys. It was The Wonderful Adventures of the Cat, Alice in Wonderland, the Mad Rabbit, or the Crazy Hatter. 3, 2, 1. Let's see the correct answer. Alice in Wonderland, of course. 6 of you win that. Wow. The positions are going to change in a minute. Number 2. She was playing with her sister when she saw the rabbit. Is that true or maybe is that false? What do you think, guys? Read carefully. Okay, I have 6 answers. Also, if you want to join to the game, guys, you can go to this ping, you can see the ping game here, okay, if you want to join. Okay, let's see the answers. That is false. She was not playing. Okay, she was not playing. Wow, now Barbara is in the first place. In the second, Edith, Roberto and Rodri are in the third place. JD in the fourth place. And finally, Ilya in the fifth place. Number three. And double points. She decided to leave her sister and follow a cat, a butterfly, a rabbit, or it was a dog. What do you think? A rabbit, of course. On the story, she was following a rabbit. Now let's go with the next. She fell into a cat's house, a pool, cave, or rabbit's hole. Here we have five answers. 15 seconds more. Rabbit hole. Wow, Edith, you're on fire. I see it. Now, this is a true or false with double points. And here it says, inside it was a tiny gold key and a green bottle that said, drink me. Is that true or false? In seconds. Well, okay, this one is true. Okay, that was true. Actually, it was real. It was a fact. Okay, let's go with the next one. After that, she decided to not drink the potion. True or false? Read carefully, guys. It was false because she decided to drink it, okay? To drink it. Wow, Roberto, Rodri, you're on fire now. Okay, let's see the next one. Pay attention, everybody. She found herself in Colegio San Angel, in a beautiful garden, her house, or a beautiful house. What do you think? Choose the correct answer, guys. Okay, we have two correct ones here. And in a beautiful garden, and in Colegio San Angel, of course, here we have it. Now let's see. Double points again. Do you remember what was Cheshire? It was a dog, a cat, an ajolote, or it was an unicorn? This is a question 8. It was a cat. Of course it was a cat. It wasn't an ajolote, guys. It wasn't an ajolote. Okay, here we have Roberto in the first place with Rodri, JD in the second place, Barbara in the third place, in the fourth we have Edith, and in the fifth place we have Paola. So let's see in the next one, true or false round. The Queen of Hearts won in the game. Was that true or that is a false thing? Six answers here. It was false remember that Alice won the game, okay? It was Alice, guys, not the Queen of Hearts. Wow. And finally, this character woke up Alice. This is our 10th question. Who was the Queen of Hearts, the rabbit, her sister, or the Cheshire cat? What do you think? Her sister, yes, at the final of the story, she woke up Alice. Remember that she touched her arm? Okay, now let's see the podium with our winners. JD, congratulations for the third place. Barbara for the second, congratulations too. And our third place is Roberto Rodri. Excellent, guys. Of course, thank you for all the people who joined to this Kahoot. We're playing with us too. Thank you so much to everybody. So now, guys, we're going to continue with more surprises for you. Here we have the Maestro Cesar. He's going to tell us about the next activity. Thank you, guys. Bye.
Muchas gracias, maestra. Hola, chicos. Buenos días. O buenas tardes, más bien. ¿Cómo están el día de hoy? Espero que estén excelentemente. Y bueno, vamos a hacer algo muy sencillo, ¿de acuerdo? Algo que me gustaría enseñarles, ¿sale? Para que se lo muestren a sus amigos también. Vamos primero a ir por algo muy sencillo, simplemente un lápiz de color o un lápiz, ¿de acuerdo? Que tengan por ahí. Puede ser una pluma, pero que la tengan por ahí, ¿sale? ¿Vale? Muy importante, ¿de acuerdo? Va que va. Porque lápiz, lápiz de color, lapicero, algo muy sencillo, ¿de acuerdo? ¿Sale, vale? Traten de mostrarlo en la pantalla para que podamos ver. ¿Ok? Excelente, muy bien. Por ahí los demás también para que abran su cámara y pueda enseñarles este truquito. ¿Ok? Este truco o esta pequeña actividad es para poner en ejercicio lo que es nuestra mente, ¿de acuerdo? Es algo muy sencillo. Vamos a tratar de poner el lápiz de color o el lápiz o lapicero así en nuestras manos, ¿de acuerdo? Que se vea de esta manera. O sea, sé que esté encima de nuestros pulgares. Así, ¿sale, vale? Muy bien. Me acomodo un poco mejor la cámara. Excelente, muy bien, que esté así. El punto es que logremos pasar este lápiz de esta manera, que se quede así. Sin que se despeguen nuestras manos. Así, miren, ¿ven? Es un ejemplo nada más, ¿sale? O sea, que pase de acá, o voy a hacer el ejemplo, y que pase acá, sin despegar nuestras manos, ¿sale? Que el lápiz que esté arriba de nuestras manos y que quede así. ¿Sale, vale? Sin despegar nuestras manos. ¿De acuerdo? Puede ser un poco complicado, pero podemos intentarlo. Ya cuando ya la vayan agarrando, ya lo pueden hacer de vuelta. ¿Sale, vale? Entonces, sin despegar nuestras manos, lo que vamos a hacer es que el lápiz de esta posición pase acá. ¿Sale, vale? Nada se preocupen, con un poco de práctica lo pueden lograr. Ok. Entonces, está así el lápiz, acuérdense, así, abrazándolo a nuestros pulgares, y tiene que pasar y de esta manera. ¿Sale, vale? Si también quieren, pueden empezar con el lápiz así, y con lo que es el dedo pulgar de abajo de la mano, de su mano derecha, agarran el lápiz y abrazan el otro pulgar. Y nada más lo pasan. ¿Sale, vale? Es igual con esto. El pulgar derecho lo vamos a poner encima del pulgar de nuestra mano izquierda y simplemente así, ¿sale? ¿Vale? Somero. Y volteamos la mano. Y ya, eso está. Muy bien, una última vez. ¿Sale? ¿Vale? Acuérdense, el pulgar derecho va a abrazar el pulgar izquierdo y simplemente volteamos la mano, ¿de acuerdo? La giramos. La giramos, ¿sale? ¿Vale? Y quedas. Bien, excelente, Jebe. Ya la agarraste. Esa gimnasia cerebral está que perfecta. Una última vez. El pulgar derecho abraza el pulgar izquierdo. ¿Sale, vale? Y tiene que quedar así. Tiramos la mano y ahí está. Sin despegar las manos. Ya le van agarrando. Excelente, Sofía. Igual la maestra Bere y la maestra Ali ya le va agarrando. Es cuestión de práctica, ¿sale? Muy bien. Bueno, pues espero les haya gustado mucho este truco, chicos. Es cuestión de práctica, eso sí. Créanme de que aquí su maestro, pues sí le tardó en agarrarle, pero es cuestión de práctica, ¿sale? Bueno, pues acuérdense de que esto es gimnasia cerebral enfocada en el mindfulness y lo pueden hacer con un simple lápiz nada más. ¿Sale, vale? Ya cuando lo agarren le pueden decir a sus amigos si pueden hacerlo y van a ver pues cómo van a intentarlo. ¿Sale? Espero les haya gustado mucho y en la siguiente va a haber otro truquito por ahí. Gracias, chicos.
Padrísimo, psicólogo César. Pues aquí estamos todos entretenidos, tratando de descifrar cómo hacer el movimiento. Así que, chicos, ya tienen una actividad para hacer con su familia. Yo sé, ya vi aquí en las camaritas algunos que sí lo lograron. Así que pueden proponer este gran truco ahorita en la comida con su familia y pues hacer este reto. ¿Qué les parece? Entonces, pues espero que les haya encantado la sesión del día de hoy. Felicitamos a todos nuestros chicos que participaron en Kahoot y estuvieron en nuestro podium el día de hoy. Los invitamos a que puedan estar con nosotros y se unan todos los sábados para pues conocer cuentos, tener un poco de actividades el día sábado en inglés, en Kahoot, actividades de mindfulness, así que no lo olviden. Y pues ustedes, si quieren, no lograron hacer esta actividad de mindfulness, esta sesión se queda grabada en nuestra cuenta de Facebook, así que pueden estarla repitiendo y visualizando hasta que puedan lograr la actividad. Y pues tenemos en nuestra barra de contenido semanal todas las sesiones a partir del día martes y finalizamos los días domingo, ¿eh? Así que mañana estén muy atentos a las 9 de la mañana, ya que vamos a tener nuestra sesión de Activémonos. Espero que les haya encantado. Muchísimas gracias, Miss Bere, por estar con nosotros en esta ocasión. Y pues a ustedes les enviamos un fuerte, fuerte abrazo con todo nuestro cariño a todos ustedes, chicos. Espero que tengan un excelente sábado.